Greetings all, welcome to my video. From the eventchronicle.com. Whistleblower Laura Eisenhower, President Eisenhower's great-granddaughter, outs secret Mars colony project. By Alfred Lambermont Webra. In a public statement, Laura Magdalene Eisenhower, great-granddaughter of former President Dwight David Eisenhower, 1890-1969, has exposed her attempted recruitment, from April 2006 through January 2007, by a secret Mars colony project. Ms. Eisenhower's account of her targeting by time travel surveillance, and attempted manipulation by trained intelligence agents, attached to a Mars colony project were revealed in an ExoPoliticsRadio.org interview, and in an extensive written statement at Ms. Eisenhower's website. Kelia, a Stanford-educated artist, futurist and colleague of Ms. Eisenhower, has provided a corroborating first-hand witness account of her, and Ms. Eisenhower's attempted recruitment into a secret human survival colony on Mars. The alleged purpose of the secret Mars colony was to provide a survival civilization for the human race on Earth, in the event of a planned, such as HAARP, or bioweapon-induced, or natural cataclysm, such as by solar flares, that might depopulate the Earth. In revealing these secret Mars colony plans, Ms. Eisenhower and Kelia have emerged to join a growing cadre of independent whistleblowers, disclosing secret technologies and extraterrestrial-related covert operations of U.S. military intelligence agencies and corporate entities. The revelations of Ms. Eisenhower and Kelia corroborate independent whistleblower revelations made by lawyer Andrew D. Bejigo of covert U.S. government surveillance of political persons of interest, using secret time travel technology. Their allegations are also consistent with disclosures made by Mr. Bejigo, that twice in 1981 he teleported from a CIA facility in El Segundo, California, to a secret U.S. base on Mars, first by himself, and then a second time in the company of CIA agent Courtney M. Hunt. Laura Magdalene Eisenhower, who has resided and traveled independently in over 20 cities in the U.S. and abroad, has developed a wide knowledge base in frontier health, natural systems, alchemy, metaphysics, and ancient history, and also has degrees and certifications in science, wilderness expedition leadership, natural healing, and building. She is a mythic cosmologist, global strategist, clairvoyant healer, earth advocate, and artist. In introducing her Mars colony revelations at exopolitics.com, Ms. Eisenhower writes, "My great-grandfather President Ike, who was also the army general who led the Allied forces to victory over Hitler, battled evil corrupt powers on Earth, and took on some of the most challenging scenarios in history. As I grew up, I could sense that I was completing this battle that has ancient roots. When Hitler died and the Nazis lost power, the entities, including those that were ET, extraterrestrial, did not. They continued to find hosts, and create agreements with people, who were a part of the races of the patriarch and global elite, who want to run things through fear tactics, control, and the suppression of Sophia, or the essence of the divine feminine." Time travel, how Laura Eisenhower was targeted by the secret Mars colony project. In her statement, Ms. Eisenhower details how Agent X, her principal, handler, from the secret Mars project, eventually confessed to her that he knew a lot about me from numerous sources that overlapped with one another, from Freemasons, Knights Templar, to this hidden branch of the government that was behind creating this Mars mission. They understood me based on remote viewing and time travel devices, and they also seemed to recruit people from the Freemasons and Knights Templar, who were well aware of the Magdalene path. They seemed to all be connected, but someone was taking advantage of it all, and trying to stay one step ahead of how nature may have unfolded, as far as us coming together into union. I did not know he was an agent until months into the relationship, and I later found out that it was them who sent him to find me, and it was all a setup. Kelia, who has worked as an accomplished, innovative, and multidisciplinary design consultant, with many renowned pioneers, corroborates the background of how Ms. Eisenhower was targeted as a subject by a shadowy group behind the secret Mars colony, using time travel and exotic targeting techniques. Kelia states, After years of friendship, in the spring of 2006 in Washington, D.C., I met her and her new romantic partner, who I will call Agent X. He claimed to know himself archetypally, as Joseph of Arimathea, Osiris, Orion, and affiliated with different, interlinked secret societies, such as Knights Templar and Freemasons. He and Laura quickly formed an intimate relationship, and I helped conduct a divine union rites of passage for them. She continues. Agent X revealed that his group had identified her through her bloodline, as the matrilineal great-granddaughter of 34th U.S. President Eisenhower. As well, they knew her as a unique reincarnation of Magdalene, Sophia, Isis, ever since she was young. Many psychics have recognized her. He also said his group was interested in her twin sons, who they knew as Romulus and Remus, founders of Rome, and the hero twin archetypes in the Mayan prophecy. Kelia writes, they had a list of male partners, who she could be with in possible timelines, and he was one of them. They targeted her, especially her heart, and these men threw electromagnetic, or psychic weaponry, and indeed many men tried to destroy her throughout her life. Agent X admitted that he, as well as his parents, was implanted with a chip, and had a multiple personality disorder, which involves very sudden robotic and abusive behaviors. This is the typical profile of someone who was subjected to well-documented MKUltra experiments and multi-generational occult ritual abuse. Kelia concludes. Their data about Laura and her partners were seemingly gathered through a time viewing device, which they had called Looking Glass, or Orion's Cube, or possibly through remote viewing, or even time travel, all part of their cadre of top classified technologies, already disclosed in increasing Black Projects literature. Timeline of the Secret Mars Project. Ms. Eisenhower, who is the mother of twin boys, writes about the evolution of her relationship with Agent X during this period of attempted recruitment into the Secret Mars Project. She states, August 2006. The plan was that I would move to Raleigh, North Carolina, and we would live together and figure this entire thing out, as Agent X kept convincing me that my vision and mission would not go unnoticed. So we made the move happen. Upon arrival, things drastically shifted. Mars would always come up again, and I was not feeling like it was safe. I felt that it was a mission being created from a hidden agenda that wished to disrupt our union and have control over it, to be used for their plots in the grander scheme of things, to assist in reseeding a civilization there. I could just sense it, because his behavior often changed and fluctuated greatly from connection with me to panic and intensity about these missions. Kelia documents Agent X's organization of the Secret Mars Project. She writes, my science and business background wasn't extensive, but as a quick multidimensional learner, I could immediately spot key alliances and best-of-breed technologies. I had made links to significantly wealthy people for my various ventures, but I continuously questioned why the heck, with all their connections, would they want me involved. Well, Agent X recognized my leadership and visionary skills and wanted funds coming through his intimate allies in order for him to achieve some equal footing with his senior advisors. Dreams and the Secret Mars Colony Project. Ms. Eisenhower explains the role of her dreams in breaking away from the attempted recruitment by the Secret Mars Colony Project. She writes, over time, the Mars issue became louder and louder. Kelia and Agent X were working on plans to make this mission happen, but she realized his plans were dubious, based on my observations, and she could only try to investigate more. She and I would talk more and more, and I would fill her in on what I was seeing. It was clear he was being mind-controlled. I even had dreams and premonitions that something was way off, and in one dream I got taken up by chains into a ship, and a voice told me I had to make a choice about being with them or staying on Earth, and that they wouldn't harm me, but they would certainly control me. In the dream, Ms. Eisenhower states, I chose Earth and fell out of the ship and fell into the ocean and was all alone in darkness. I tried to reconnect with the ship, and flew up into the air to just communicate to them, and understand things more, but thunder and lightning obscured my ability to see the ship, and I fell back into the water. Then some crazy alignment happened, and all these planets were surrounding me, this organic light filled my being, and I knew I made the choice for Gaia, which connected with my deep awareness of what I am here to create. Plus, I naturally have adverse reactions to being controlled in any way, so I knew it was my only choice. Ms. Eisenhower continues. I told Agent X the dream, and he was nervous, but we stayed together, and I continued to observe him, while feeling a broken heart deep inside. I knew I was losing him to them. Ms. Eisenhower writes. I said I did not want to go to Mars, even if there were Earth catastrophes, and I felt confident especially after that dream, but he said I had to, and if I didn't they would kidnap me. His behavior got worse and worse, and he was dealing with all kinds of death threats, and there was no way he was able to pull out of their grips, or stay on Earth with me. In the aftermath of breaking away from the secret Mars colony project, after January 2007, Ms. Eisenhower writes. Key Leah and I discovered that in order for the secret Mars colony to have their matrix of control, they wanted the Magdalene Isis and Osiris seeding of Mars, or the power of the Holy Grail, which means royal blood. After so many readings throughout my life, confirmed this as my identity, not just essence, it all started to make sense, but in a way that was hard for me to want to communicate, or own up to, except for within. I knew my energy field, heart and intention was strong enough, as a personification of the Venus calendrical path, which everyone can access, to help regenerate Gaia and Mars, and shift us into the positive, awakening of consciousness. Ms. Eisenhower states, I knew this would lead to the liberation, from the controls that have kept us imprisoned for so long. Time travel, political surveillance, of U.S. presidential persons of interest, a lawyer in Washington State, and president of the Mars Anomaly Research Society, Andrew D. Bejigo, has revealed the existence of a secret DARPA time travel program, in which he was a childhood participant, that included the identification of future persons of interest, utilizing different forms of quantum access, beginning in the early 1970s. On a November 11, 2009, Coast to Coast AM radio program, Mr. Bejigo publicly stated that this DARPA program involving time travel was identifying future persons of interest, including those who would serve as U.S. president, and then informing such persons of their destinies. Mr. Bejigo stated that in the early 1970s, in the company of his late father, Raymond F. Bejigo, an engineer for the Ralph M. Parsons Company, who worked on classified aerospace projects, he was present at a lunch in Albuquerque, New Mexico, at which future U.S. Presidents George H.W. Bush and George W. Bush were guests shortly after they were informed that both would one day serve as president. He also stated that in the early 1970s, the DARPA program, Project Pegasus, had identified future presidents Jimmy Carter and Bill Clinton, utilizing time travel technology, and that when Mr. Bejigo met future President Barack Obama in Los Angeles, California, in 1982, when Mr. Bejigo was attending UCLA, and Mr. Obama, then a student at Columbia University, was visiting former classmates at Occidental College in Los Angeles, a statement made by the ally of Mr. Obama, in the anti-apartheid movement, that had introduced them, revealed that Mr. Obama, then age 20, already knew that he would one day be president. Mr. Bejigo revealed that the reason Project Pegasus was able to identify Mr. Carter, who was then governor of Georgia, in 1971, as a future U.S. president, is that the program was in possession of a copy of the Universe Books edition of Exopolitics, Politics, Government, and Law in the Universe, by Alfred Lambermont Webra, a book that this reporter would not write until 2005, but which bears a quote on its front pages, of a statement made by President Jimmy Carter. According to Mr. Bejigo, Mr. Webra's book Exopolitics was, among other written works, physically retrieved from the future, by Project Pegasus, and brought back in time to 1971, or a prior time. At that time, 1971, Mr. Weber was general counsel of the New York City Environmental Protection Administration, and had been placed under time travel surveillance by the U.S. government. Thus, there is historical precedent for the covert political surveillance, via remote sensing in time, of a person of interest, like Lorem Magdalene Eisenhower, great-granddaughter of U.S. President Dwight D. Eisenhower. U.S. secret bases on Mars, and intelligent life on Mars, Ms. Eisenhower's and Key Lea's account of a secret Mars colony, designed as a survival civilization for the human race, is plausible within the context of independent whistleblower evidence, regarding a secret U.S. presence on Mars. There is now independent whistleblower evidence of secret U.S. bases on Mars. Mr. Bejigo, formerly involved in secret research and development projects undertaken by a U.S. defense agency, has verified his secret teleportation to U.S. bases on Mars, and to meeting intelligent Martian extraterrestrial life. Mr. Bejigo confirms that the United States has been teleporting individuals to Mars for decades, and recounts the awe-inspiring and terrifying trips that he took to Mars in 1981, after he was tapped to go there because he had teleported as a child participant in Project Pegasus. Mr. Bejigo has also publicly confirmed that in 1970, in the company of his late father, Raymond F. Bejigo, he met three Martian astronauts at the Curtis Wright Aeronautical Company facility in Woodridge, New Jersey, while the Martians were there on a liaison mission to Earth and meeting with U.S. aerospace personnel. Ms. Eisenhower and Key Lea appear to be following a trend of whistleblowers predicted by the WebBot project. A September 15, 2009 report, using asymmetric language trend analysis, ALTA, of data collected by the WebBot predicts that it is very likely that the whistleblower, who had been described in previous ALTA reports as emerging out of the period of the coagulation of the government, officialdom, of the U.S. of A, due to financial structure collapse, is a person by the name of Andrew D. Bejigo. The ALTA report predicted that a trend of whistleblowers would follow Mr. Bejigo's initial revelations. Public investigation, and a return to the divine feminine, as whistleblowers of a secret Mars colony project, Lorem Magdalene Eisenhower, and Key Lea, ask for a further public investigation. Ms. Eisenhower writes, "All I ask is that this be further investigated. There is still much to uncover and piece together. It is crucial that the truth is revealed, and that world leaders disclose their files related to any cover-ups of ET and UFO relations, and have the ethics and integrity to look deeper into the use of technologies, such as ELF and HARP. I hope that citizens of this planet embrace with an open mind their true origins and relationship with universal society, and share this information with others." Key Lea asks that serious investigations be made into the real agenda and cover-up of the currently existing Mars colony as a survival plan for a planned, or foreseen, disastrous Earth timeline. In her in-depth ExoPoliticsRadio.org interview, Lorem Magdalene Eisenhower calls for a return of the divine feminine. She writes in her public statement, "The archonic patriarchal energies have had a manipulative hold on the life force and creativity of Gaia for thousands of years, personified as Sophia the goddess. Our Mother Earth is more powerful than these lower energies though, but to instantly break free of the dysfunction would mean a mass apocalypse and the re-establishment of a new creation. To let go and lose awareness would result in being taken away on an agenda that has been in the works, with the intention of reseeding a new civilization on Mars, under the selfish control of the global elite, therefore leaving the Earth to atrophy and self-destruct." Ms. Eisenhower states, "The Mother Energy loves us though beyond our comprehension, and is patient and determined to create global transformation, regenerate, and reunite with Heaven, through the cycles of nature, and the path of Venus." Key Lea states, "We call every single person of every age, race, faith, and background, to stand up for the truth of our loving and laughing eternal soul nature. Our collective and internal reunion with the divine feminine and masculine. Our power of consciousness to heal, travel, and manifest instantaneously. And our magnificent galactic heritage and destiny. We must rebuild our civilization and restore our lost paradise, Atlantis, Shamhala, Eden, or heaven on earth. Alfred Lambermont Webra, J.D., Med., is known as the founding father of exopolitics, the new political science of outer space, the science of relations between human society and other intelligent civilizations. This article, whistleblower Laura Magdalene Eisenhower, Ike's great-granddaughter, OUT's secret Mars colony project, was originally published on Bibliotheca Pleiades and syndicated by the Event Chronicle via Stillness in the Storm. Thank you for watching. Please help spread the word and make a difference by sharing and subscribing for more thought-provoking content, and give us a thumbs up if you liked the video. Your support is greatly appreciated. Be aware and stay safe.